What's up? What's up?
So you're obviously the star of this whole show, right?
Yeah, obviously.
He exists in a world beyond your world.
Do I have to see my bicep in high condition?
No.
Come on inside. Jesus. How's it look?
Sup, bruh? Call me Mr. Acidic.
Here we go. Basically, how did I start with bodybuilding? Well, throughout high school, I was always an extreme endomorph. I could eat pretty much anything I wanted to, not put on any fat at all. And after I finished year 12, I started getting into training because my brother was training at the time. And basically I learned pretty much everything I had to learn in the gym itself, rather than doing proper research that I should have done. I never went online, did anything like that for the first couple of months, and that probably hindered a lot of my progress that I could have made. Because I did start off doing simple isolations like bicep curls, shit like that. You got to be doing compound squatting, deadlifting. That's what's going to make your body. And I'm telling you right now, if you fuck around in the gym, if you fuck around doing a few bicep curls, if you isolate, you need to get the base first. So you need to fucking train as hard as you can and push yourself. You need to put yourself on a level where your body doesn't want to keep going. And when you reach that point, you keep going. And what you will see is basically your body will be put into overdrive, and that's how gains are made. It's not made by going to a gym and just fucking around with your mates, having a laugh, doing a few sets. You're not going to get a good body like that. You've got to push yourself past that brink. Your body doesn't want to change naturally. That's why you've got to force yourself. And don't forget that dieting is one of the most important things. If you're not dieting, you're not going to get the results you want. It's simple as that. So you could be training, having a fucking epic workout, whatever, but if you're not eating properly, you might as well not be training. Another question in regards to my diet. Well, I do have two different types of diets. There's basically a bulking diet and a cutting diet. Personally, I have an extremely fast metabolism, which means I can eat a lot of food and not convert that to fat. And that's just based on my ectomorph body type. This isn't the case with everyone. My whole life, I had a fast metabolism, so that proved to be a positive factor in my training. But that's not the same for everyone. A lot of people find that they have a piece of chocolate or something like that, they'll notice it straight away. So that's quite unfortunate for them, but you gotta do what best for pretty much what you're given. Alright, basically with your bulky meal, you're gonna have carbs and meat every single meal. Try to get steak, chicken, pasta, everything like that, brown rice, fish. You wanna get meat and protein every single meal. Best way to grow is to eat meat. That's what I found when I was eating. Fucking eat some meat, fucking put on the most size. So definitely try to eat some meat. And pretty much force yourself to eat until you can't have any more bites, because you want to push your body past that point. You're already breaking down the muscle fibers by training. Now what you've got to do is replenish the nutrients in your body and grow. So So basically you have to keep eating and eating and eating, and it takes time. It's not a quick fix, so just keep eating and you will see the results. Cutting diet's a lot different. Personally, I do a ketogenic diet basically means you completely cut out all carbs. Now, if you're cutting out all carbs, basically what that means is that your body, in about 3 or 4 days' time, will reach a state known as ketosis. And what that does is it uses the body's fat as energy rather than stored carbohydrates. And that is definitely my favorite type of diet for losing fat. It's really, really hard to keep it up in the beginning, especially considering the fact that if you're used to eating heaps of carbs and you stop, your body craves it. So it's really, really a mind game trying to push through that pain. But let me tell you now, it's worth it if you do and you keep that diet up. A couple of weeks, you'll start noting yourself getting leaner and leaner, your skin getting tighter. It's a fucking really good diet. So pretty much all your meals will be, you can get a bit of carbs, but you got to keep it under 50 grams and make sure it comes all from green vegetables. Personally, I get it from broccoli and spinach, and I just leave it at that. So say a meal will be something like 8 eggs, something like that, and then a small portion of spinach. Another meal will be 200 grams of tuna with a bit of broccoli in it. Another meal will be boiled chicken with a bit of spinach. You can have sardines, you can have grilled fish, cottage cheese, pretty much anything like that. And it is pretty annoying, you get sick of it, but it does work, and I definitely recommend it. So that's pretty much all I'm going to talk about for now. Miami, bro.
Hi, Umar. Come at me, bro. Come at me, bro.
Hi, guys. This is Maina, and I'm here to complain once again like a woman should. Hey, you have a great body, I must admit. I'm a joke to that. Good body. But your personality is very shit.
We'll be right back. One day, I was at a club called DCM in Oxford Street in Sydney, and I started dancing on the podium, as we do with our muzzle dancing, etc. And he just stared at me for like 30 seconds, came up to me, and out of nowhere, he just said, "Fuck." He goes, "That's crazy, I want to learn that." So then we actually connected on a really personal, different level. And very quickly, we became very, very close, not just like friends, but he actually felt like a long lost brother that I had. Out of nowhere, he stopped on the middle of the bridge where there's the main walkway from one side of the festival to the other. And he just looked around, decided, "Fuck this, I'm just going to take off my shorts," and pulled them down, took off his shirt, started walking around in his Calvin Klein underwear. Everyone was just staring like, "What the hell is this guy actually doing?" Like, girls are staring and just gasping and tapping their friends' arms going, "Look at this guy, look at this guy." And guys are like, "What the fuck?" He had the people that were hating, obviously, just as they do. And I was walking for a few minutes and I'm like, "Don't you care what people are saying? People are talking behind your back." He just looked at me, gave me a look and just said, "If you give a fuck people think, you're not going to get anywhere." And he goes, "Fuck it, I'm shredded."
Al wasn't just the best mate for me. I'd say he was like a brother to me. You know, he was my mentor. He was the person that taught me everything I know. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be who I am, and I wouldn't have any of the beliefs that I got right now. You know, if it wasn't for Al, I wouldn't have lived life the way I do now. The main thing that Al probably taught me is the fact that, you know, you're literally given a chance of life only once, and that one time, you've got to make it count. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be doing anything I'm doing right now, you know? Right now, I'm not just letting life straight past me. I'm living it up. I'm making sure that every second counts, making sure that every second spent with my best mates, with my brothers, and with my family. I'm making everything count. And why do I make it count? Because I have put it in my head that, you know what, Aiden? You've got to make it count. You give him one chance, do it. He taught me to respect life. He taught me to respect the chance that I'm given and to make it count. You know, he was my mentor, my brother. That's all I can say.
There's one time in the car where he asked me if I have sex with my own mother for $5 million. And it was one of those things where I was like, "No, you know, I don't do that for $5 million. And he asked me to do it for $10 million. And it was just one of those moments where it was so funny, and we had to stop the car because we were laughing so hard. In one word, Az was, I'd have to say, charismatic. He had a level of charisma that was totally unmatched by anybody that I'd ever met before. And, you know, it's easy to see in his videos and say, "Wow, I like to hang around this far, he's funny or whatnot." When you meet him in person, it's just on a whole other level. Even if he wasn't, you know, if he didn't have the, you know, the internet celeb status that he had, he'd still, wherever he went, people would look at him, and whoever met him would want to, like, get to know him. And he had one of those personalities where you just want to be around him all the time.
We're at Bondi Beach, and it was a really beautiful day, so as we were leaving, it was gridlock traffic, and Az looks over to the diagonal direction, and he sees this convertible, and in it is this Indian guy in his mid-30s and kind of balding already. But next to him is this blonde bombshell, absolutely stunning. And he looks to me and he says, "Man, that is the biggest gold digger I've ever seen in my life. Do you have the song?" And I'm like, I knew exactly what he was thinking, so I put the song on and he turns it up to max. He pulled up side by side with their car, and Az has got the remote in his hand and keeps on rewinding it. Keeps going, "She take my money, she take my money, she take my money." And we were absolutely in tears at this point in time. We looked over at them and she was, he was fuming at this point, and she was leaning on his shoulder trying to comfort him.
Being siblings, and more so brothers, there's always some sort of a rivalry between the two. Whatever it may be, you know, better grades, who's got the better body, or whatnot. One festival I do remember is Sensations 2008, where we actually had a competition to see who's going to come in more shredded. And what happened was, you know, I actually managed to come in a little bit leaner than he did. And Az was not one to always pay compliments or let people know that he was beaten. And you know, and he came up to me on the countdown and he just goes, "Bro, I just want to say, you look absolutely fucking amazing. I'm very proud of you. You've outdone me. Congratulations, well done." And that's going to be a memory that I'm going to hold on to for the rest of my life. And it was a very beautiful moment. We hugged each other, we kissed, then the beat dropped and we started.
This is crap. This is a fucking revolution, bro. We're taking over. One at a time. Admire, bro.
Yeah!
mad. Bruh.